this time. But we gotta grow up sometime. Sometime. We gotta grow up sometime. Yeah, because we look so good and look so young. We just wanna have some fun. But we gotta grow up sometime. Next verse. Hey, Bobby, hey, Bobby. I saw you in the lobby. If you see my CD, go ahead and pick you up.
So, oh, you can see me. Hello, me.
Hello, me.
Hey, girls. Welcome to the latest episode of the Crown Jewels podcast. I am your host, Tika Rose, here with my co-hosts,
Kelly Vaughn
and Alexis Alexander.
If you don't know our names by now, something's wrong with you. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, like our Facebook page, like all of our social media pages. If you can't find it, tell me, and we'll make sure that that's where we are, so you can tell all your friends about it. How's it been going, gals? Everyone's winning the day.
I'm excited to be here, I can say that much.
Me too, yeah, I've missed you ladies.
I missed you too.
I need your positive energy to build. Too.
I've never expected you to say something like, I miss you. That's so sweet.
But
it's so sweet,
you.
Though.
I do. Well, you know, I work all the time. Maybe not soon, but whatever. So it's nice to connect with people, with like-minded people. It's just nice to connect with. So I did miss you guys.
Miss you
I've
too.
Been surrounded by colonizers.
You know what?
I need some melanin in my life.
Yeah. You are not slick. You miss us because your birthday's coming up.
Oh, that is right.
My birthday's always coming up, first of all. No. My birthday's always coming up. The day after my birthday's coming up. Okay?
That's so, such a smart-ass thing to say.
But I
the day after my birthday, my birthday's coming up.
Coming up.
You got a birthday that's coming soon.
My birthday's coming up, but my birthday's coming up.
When is your birthday?
December. No, ma'am. Negative.
My birthday's actually in July, and you guys are... Anyway,
so,
we need to...
April 28th. Yeah. I'm always accepting gifts. Send me whatever you like.
Or me, and I'll give them to her after
no,
I check them out and make sure that I don't want them.
Send them directly to me.
We all accept gifts for her birthday. Okay?
It's just like we all had a part in birthing my child.
Yes. This is the same story.
We were there with you. Supporting your mom as she was pushing.
Wait, what?
We were.
Well, when I was being born.
Yes.
Oh.
I mean, she was there.
I thought I was the oldest.
I actually am the youngest of this crew.
I'm not
the
oldest.
I wasn't even born.
I am the oldest. Wait, how? I will be 39 on my birthday.
You're the oldest.
Oh, look how mature I am.
And beautiful. Like, come on now.
Very mature.
Well, now I'm only 27, so.
And beautiful.
You're right. You're the oldest.
Because you don't want to say
she said 27. How old is your child?
37. That's the one. We're not talking about that.
Her baby's 37.
Okay.
So, spring's not here yet.
No.
It's trying.
It's here, but it's not.
It's not. It's trying.
It's here, but it's not.
I mean,
it's gonna be here for
it's like,
hours.
It's warm. We had that, like, almost a 2-week stretch of warmth in, what was it, January, February time frame?
Mm-hmm.
I knew it. The minute spring hit, we get a snowstorm, a little retardedness, a nor'easter.
Yeah. Several.
This is stupid.
Yeah, but I said that. I said a few weeks ago, I put on my Facebook page, I said, enjoy this weather now. Because in a few weeks, it's going to be snow and ice.
Give me my sunshine.
I mean,
all
we
want
have sunshine, but
no,
we don't have like the warmth that
I need
comes
the
with
warmth.
Sunshine. Yeah.
I need the warmth.
Yeah.
And I want to not have to wear so many clothes every day. Clothes are stupid.
So you want to stretch is what you're saying.
She just wants to be
fresh.
Take it off. Take it out.
Well, by your birthday, you'll be able to
take
do that.
Take it out.
Put on my birthday suit. You can do that now. But
you can actually do that now.
After this.
That's a special edition, you guys.
Special edition of the Crown Jewels.
Yeah.
Alexis will wear her birthday suit.
She Alexis didn't say that, actually.
Not at all.
She volunteered the suit, so I just
you actually
she
did.
She wanted to put it
you
on.
You said birthday suit.
I don't, you know.
And that means, what does that mean? Does that mean nudity or does that mean like lingerie? What is the actual birthday suit?
That means nothing.
But bucket naked.
Okay.
Exactly.
Bucket it
naked. I didn't know that because I'm so nothing innocent. Else. I wouldn't know what a birthday suit means.
Nice.
Wow. I will have a child, but like until him, I was a virgin.
Immaculate.
All right, so we won't comment on that.
So anyway, so no spring yet. Maybe it's waiting for my birthday.
It's waiting for your birthday. That's when it's going to hit. The sun is going to come out. 70 degree weather is going to come. It's coming on your birthday.
Perfect. Well, I think we're having a beautiful day today.
It is. It is really pretty.
Well, can I share, the sun is out. Can I share with you guys what really was disturbing to me this past week?
Sure.
OJ
Simpson?
You know that interview came out?
the If I Did It.
Yeah.
He's an idiot.
It's so, I haven't seen it.
But you need
just
to explain
the thought of yeah. him.
You gotta explain it though to our viewers.
Yeah, so the interview was recorded about 12 years ago, I think it was some years ago before he went to jail.
Oh, it was old.
Okay. It's old. It was recorded when he came out with that book.
If I did it,
yeah.
Man.
So basically, he's just talking about that book in a hypothetical mm-hmm. type format.
Yeah. He won't stop. He won't shut up.
He won't. I didn't see the actual confession. I mean, the actual interview. I didn't see the actual interview.
Cute,
and right? I didn't read the book. I'm not going to read the book. But I did see a clip of it. And when I was watching the clip of it, he was talking about how he didn't realize that after a person is dead, if you're angry at them, the anger doesn't die when they die.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. So, he's psycho.
But that made me think about something. Now, the good thing from that is that is something that people need to watch and hear his crazy self, because he sounds just like a physical abuser.
Yes. I agree.
For sure.
He was blaming her.
Yes.
For making him do something.
Yes.
Yeah. It's her fault. I had to do this.
Now, I didn't see him actually confessing to the murder, even though he did it. Yeah. But he was talking about an incident that happened a few months before she died. Mm-hmm. And he was blaming her for he was saying that she made him react the way that he did.
Yeah. Well, let me ask you this. You're saying now he did it. I think we were in high school when this trial happened.
No, we were in middle school.
You were in high school.
I
wasn't born yet.
I'm pretty sure I was
We were.
I think I watched the trial in my 10th grade English class. Like the results.
I could have sworn we were in middle school. But okay, go ahead.
I'll fact check myself, but I'm almost certain of that.
Doesn't
and I
matter,
feel
but.
Like, you know, they show, there's like videos and memes of people's, of the very differing reactions of people having, like, all the black people were cheering and all the white people were pissed. And, you know, I actually saw a video that showed that, and I shared it on my Facebook page, just saying this, you know, look at the difference. And I don't think we as a people have been forgiven since. And I think that was a pivotal point in the structuring of white and black people, because they have since excelled astronomically in fields of finance and wealth and real estate, while we have stayed where we are or declined from where we were. Yeah. And I think it's the get back. Well, you know, let us put ourselves in this position. And now there's such a huge gap between the racial growth and so many different variances. It's ridiculous. But back to my original question.
But I would say this, though. Mm-hmm. Back to what you said about the abuser. I mean, that is something to look at. Because if you sit here and you think about anything where you've been in a relationship or in a situationship with someone, and they actually blamed you for the reason why they hurt you, they hit you, they got either physical or verbally abusive with you, that has a lot of impact on us as a people. As people of color, we need to have these discussions, because then it makes me jump into what you said about the fact that people of color never even took the time to look at the fact that what he was doing, even if we don't believe he did it, which I know I do, I know you guys do, but even if you don't believe he did it, the fact that we knew enough to know he was abusive and we cheered for him to be free. So that right there in itself is a good conversation to be having amongst other African American people. We need to address these issues of violence against women, and we need to stop acting like it doesn't matter because, well, he was black and white people have done enough damage to us that we can overlook what he did and we want his freedom to represent us. No, we don't want his freedom to represent us because, right, in essence, what we're saying, if we say that, we say that it's okay for a man to be abusive as long as she's white.
But that same overlooking goes into
families. It's not okay.
Families have become, and I'll say, you know, white families do it too, but black families are really bad for trying to brush stuff under the rug.
Yes,
and in the family business. Or, oh, I know this is going on, I'm just, you know, I'm going to turn a blind eye to it.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, that's how things get overlooked until something's going to happen to that girl. You know, they'll talk about it amongst themselves, each other. They'll take it to church. They'll pray on it until the sun comes up. No, you take action and do things.
Yeah,
why not address the person who's doing the wrongdoing, and you know that they're doing it.
Exactly.
Yeah, there were jokes made about O.J. Simpson after that happened. There were comedians that took the floor to use that as an opportunity to make it humorous. Whether he murdered her or not, physical violence and abuse against women needs to stop, and it should not be taken lightly. So that, to me, should have been an opportunity. It should be a teachable moment, even for him to come back and say this dumb stuff that he's saying now. It should be a teachable moment in our community that this is not ever okay.
Right.
Like, this is not funny, and it's not ever going to be a time where it will be funny because somebody died. And you say, well, black people die all the time. This has nothing to do with that. You're comparing apples to oranges. And you need to address the fact that society has made it seem okay to abuse and batter women, and then when there's nothing left, kill her.
Right.
You know, and there is something to be said that we can make jokes, or comedians can make that humorous, or anybody could say or make light of that situation. He needs to disappear from talking in public. I'm done with you, OJ.
Done with you too.
Just for fact-checking purposes, the verdict was read October 3rd, 95. So we were in high school.
Okay.
Yes, sir. I wasn't born yet.
I think Alexis had started her career already.
Damn.
Graduated college.
I was about to say, I was just born. I was still in diapers.
But I will say this. He definitely, you know, back then, maybe we wanted him to be innocent because, oh, so many years, our black men have been convicted, guilty.
Wrongfully,
for so many things.
Instantly guilty.
There's so many people that's in jail right now that should never have been. There's so many cases of where it was apples to apples comparison of charges brought against them, but because they were black, they got 20 plus years more than the other people. So there's the system is broken.
The system is completely
shot. It's us. and it was never written for us anyway. So how about revisiting the Constitution to be rewritten to include all the people in America, as it's supposed to be an inclusive country? That's why all the people migrated here years ago. Everybody's a damn immigrant. Some voluntarily, some involuntarily. Only the Native Americans can claim this land. But anyway.
Well, can be left up for, because I believe we were here too.
We may have been.
We were here too.
We may have migrated here.
What we know as today of as Native Americans, but we call ourselves African Americans, but there is.
I don't even call myself that.
Yeah, I don't either, but you know, that's what I'm saying in general. We overall call ourselves that.
Yeah.
But,
right, and we're the only race that are called that.
Yeah.
Just why?
Yeah.
But, okay.
But even the name Native Americans, but we.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. The indigenous.
Yeah.
But anywho's, OJ shouldn't say shit. He should just shut up, stay in his little corner in Vegas, wherever he's at. Stop talking about it. Stop hypothetically placing yourself in a situation, because you would think the karma of his ass getting caught for stealing his own shit back would have been enough.
How funny is that, though?
That would have, you thought it would have been
that's
enough.
That's when he finally paid some
how
price.
How funny is that? But if you think about it, if you were to hypothetically get away with killing two people,
he's gonna.
Would you really sit in the corner and be quiet?
Yeah. Murder two people.
Well, because OJ is not a typical type of person. You're talking about a narcissistic psychopath. He is into himself, and from the beginning,
absolutely,
he didn't represent black people. So stop talking.
He's OJ.
Black people stop trying to crowd around this idea. But now all of a sudden, it's almost like not only are they not, black people are not crowding around OJ like they did during the case. It just feels so, it feels so destructive to even have ever crowded around him before. He was never for black people. He was for himself. And so if he is that selfish of a man, disappear. Be alone. Right. Be alone in your thoughts. But don't talk out loud in public or to anyone in an interview. Shut the hell up. I'm sorry,
it's
understandable, but you know how many people feel like that?
You're annoying. Go away.
Yeah. So, yeah, he definitely lost the blacking.
Yeah.
The backing of black people.
He just didn't he shouldn't have ever had it.
He should not have ever had it, but that's what we do. We celebrate celebrities for the most insane, mundane reasons.
Because they're black.
Because they're black, or because of their status that you think is celebrated. You know, I know so many more people who deserve applause and attention.
Humanitarian.
Yeah.
Like, be a humanitarian. If you got away with murder, or if you, like you say, you didn't do it, if you got away with something, which would be at least the abuse of this woman, if you got away with something, be a better person. You know, this is my whole thing is be a humanitarian now. Be on search for how to help make this world a better place. Don't be an asshole.
So, Alexis, why did you know, you started off saying that upset you. So what specifically upset you about it? Just that he's out here, you know, because he's talking.
He's using that to continue to make himself relevant.
Yes.
His children, if for no other reason, think about his freaking children. His children lost their mother.
Right. Never cared about that.
She was killed at her house and her friend.
So if you didn't do it, consider his
children.
Yeah.
He's selfish.
Continue to relive that and continue to discuss that? Why would you put out a book and then do a recorded interview saying, hypothetically, if I would have killed two people, this is how I would have done it. This is what I would have said. This is how I would have reacted.
But that's what makes him look even more guilty.
Right. But in his small mind,
it's all that he has to hold on to remain relevant,
like you said.
Yeah.
He's you know, scraping for attention.
Well, you gotta think about anything to do with him, not white people, not black people. Think about it. He was known for being the Jews. So now when he is passed by people, you gotta imagine the reaction from white people. You know, you gotta imagine the reaction from the people that he wanted the approval of, which is white people. He wanted white people's approval, and now they have nothing but disdain for this man. So he's still speaking about it because he's still trying to, in some way, say, I'm innocent to those people, to those white people he wanted the approval of that hate him now.
I don't think he's trying to do that now. I think now is for his own.
It's for him. He's selfish, too. He's still narcissistic.
Self-gratification to say,
yeah,
I got away with it, and what?
Right.
But anyway, I don't want to continue to give him our time and energy. But if you do happen to watch it, pay attention, because his actions and the way that he speaks 100% are signs of abusers.
Yes, absolutely.
They have the same patterns. Trust me.
Yeah.
We know what we're talking about.
Right.
Yeah,
but, you know, people know these things and they see these things and they have to position themselves to start making these changes.
But I don't think that everybody knows that.
I think it's such a small number of people that wouldn't understand the signs.
But they
choose to look beyond it. Yeah, I mean, if you're the people, I don't know any race that doesn't, you know, have these issues within their community.
Yeah.
You know, I don't care how much quiet is kept in your home. Somebody knows something. Your neighbors know something. They hear it. They see it. Your school, your job, everybody knows certain signs.
Yeah.
It's just too obvious at times. And some people may really be oblivious to it. But, you know, all you got to do is pay a little bit more attention to other people. It's just like how, you know, I'm sure you guys are both very polite ladies. I have a habit of saying, and, you know, I've heard this discussion before. Hey, how you doing? Just speaking to someone, hello, how you doing? And, you know, they're automatically fine. But sometimes some people will go into the answer mode where I might be like, hi, how are you? And they'll answer and then continue to answer other things I haven't even asked because they're not listening.
Right.
They're just trained to
yeah.
program and spit
answer
out that rhetoric fine. That, you know, and it's just like, well, you didn't even hear what I said. You know, let's try this again. Or I'll just say hi and somebody's like, yeah, I'm fine. Well, I didn't
yeah.
ask.
That has happened to me.
I didn't
before.
Even ask,
yeah.
but
ask,
thank
but,
you.
Yeah.
I was going to get there.
Right.
So people don't pay attention. They're wrapped up in their own world,
yeah,
their own
yeah.
things. You know,
which
be a
is,
little bit more observant.
Yeah, yeah. Do something different. Be a part of the change you want to see. Don't
mm-hmm.
sit by and say, you know, I can't stand OJ because he does this. But then somewhere inside of you is that same type of person that she just talked about. He was saying, which is, you know, blaming the victim, blaming the person.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can't do that and become a better person. You can never do that and be your best self.
Right.
So start to look within, and I do that. I do that. If I get angry about something, like OJ, this conversation we're having about OJ, then I have to look within, and like I have to make sure every day that I'm not being a victim or playing the victim, because I was a victim of domestic abuse.
Right.
So you have to be the change that you wish to see, but you also have to call out bullshit.
And you are responsible for your own
yes.
reactions and how you react to stuff. You can't blame other people for that.
Yep. But, you know, that's one thing that I think mental health, you know, you got to care for yourself mentally.
That's such a conversation
and
for the Black community.
It definitely
right,
is.
Right, because that's not something that we often discuss.
No.
You have to be mentally, you know, responsible for yourself. You know, you meet these people that are, you know, gym rats, you know, all about veganism, holistic healing. That's
right,
great.
That's
one very important aspect of that is your mind. If you are in any way, you know, not feeling a certain way, some things just aren't dismissive as a, you know, bottle of beer or some weed or whatever, you know, your medicine. The gym might be your medicine. You
right.
still need to seek and look into mental health. It's very important, and I think it's something that has always been, you know, shied away from within the Black
Absolutely.
Community.
I agree.
You know, there's something to be said there. You have to look a little bit deeper. So if you ever have the tools and resources, just check it out. Most employers offer EAP assistance. There's counselors worldwide. All you got to do is Google it. If you're feeling down, you need someone to talk to. If you go to church, you can start there. You know, don't put all your eggs in one basket. Seek out different
that's
ways.
It.
But
that's it.
That's
take
that,
care of yourself.
That could save us a lot of people some problems.
Yeah.
Right.
It could save a lot of lives, because there
yeah.
are a lot of people walking around today that are basically just living. They're just being, but they're not really living. I'm
right.
sorry, they're being, but they're not living. And it's because mental health has been an issue for the Black community. It's an issue in all communities, but it's a deeper issue, a deeply rooted issue in the Black community, and it's not being dealt with.
Right.
So, yeah, seek out the help that you need. I agree 100% we need to do that. And it's on an individual basis. It's not for you to tell someone else. Because we all have our stuff.
We
look
do.
Within. Start working to better yourself. Like she said, don't just be a gym rat and make sure your body is looking right. I mean, that's great. But
your
if
right.
your mind is not right, we dropping jewels. Like, if your mind ain't right, you ain't right.
I love our jewel sprinkle.
Yeah, that sprinkle. I saw it. On both sides.
Well, I think that's just responsible. And I'm going to say this. I think a lot of ladies seek out the guidance from other women. Now, don't get me wrong. I think it's healthy to you know, have that space to vent. Especially, you know, if you're surrounded by positive women, while it's important to have that a great support system from your friends, especially if it's positive women, like Kelly was saying, you never know what's going on in someone else's life. Everybody has their stuff and their baggage, but even if they have, you think they have no baggage, they've got it all together, you can't say this person is mentally secure and has the answers to diagnose me with anything. You really got to seek out a professional for that sort of thing. You never know what somebody's motives may be behind telling you, or even their belief system. Do your own research.
Right.
Always do your own research. Never, ever, ever put all your eggs in the baskets of somebody else, because you don't know where they're coming from.
Right, what they're dealing with. Right, right. And I would say the other thing too is, because I thought you were going to say it actually, but like you said, a lot of women reach out to positive women, and that's great, but a lot of women, and a lot more women I think, tend to put all their emotion into a relationship. Mm-hmm. And while we have already crossed over that bridge of abuse, I have to say that women who want to be loved and want to feel love, they put everything into that relationship with another person, which is typically, if we're talking about black women, we're talking about them putting that into a black man. And a lot of times, because again, we haven't dealt with a lot of mental health issues, you're putting all your worth into the black man who may have his own insecurities. And his insecurities will only add to yours and create more mental health issues. Let's start fixing ourselves. Start really being a better you by making sure you address these internal issues.
Right.
Right.
People have the power. How can you properly love yourself?
Yeah.
I'll tell you guys about that.
Okay.
I'm sorry, what was that?
You can't properly love someone else if you're not properly taking care of loving yourself.
That's it.
And healing.
Heal.
Your insecurities first.
Take a break from your relationships, and if you have someone in your life and you know that that person is not good for you, take a break from them. I know it hurts at first and it feels like you might lose it all, but it's better to lose that one person than to lose yourself.
Right.
Take a break, and I love that you said that. Heal. Take a break and heal. Take the time to heal, and then when you get back out there and you're back out there dating again, you'll be prepared to choose better for yourself. You'll be better for yourself.
I agree. So since we're talking about relationships. Not my relationship.
Are you looking for your relationship right now?
No.
Like, since we're talking about it, you looked at us all coy.
Yeah.
What's up?
Prince Harry.
Okay.
That's the one that's engaged, right?
Yeah.
Okay, Prince Harry and Meghan.
Markle.
What's her last name?
Meghan Markle.
Yeah, that's her.
Meghan Markle. So I just heard recently that he doesn't want a prenup.
I don't hate him for it.
I don't hate him for it.
But
I'm sure his grandmother does.
I'm sure the queen does. Yeah. I'm sure the queen does.
Oh, hell no.
That.
She's going to turn around in her pillbox hat. Angrily.
Yeah, very angrily. Very angrily. But I think that there's something to say about that relationship
What does it say?
I mean, in my eyes, I see a very genuine couple, that they are genuinely in love. He genuinely pursued her, and he genuinely fights every day all these blogs and all these shows that talk about him and his relationship with her. He fights for her. And I think that, you know, there's something to say about relationship today and marriage today that's all about a piece of paper. Versus his relationship seems to be more genuine, and it doesn't seem to be about money. It seems to be about love. Like, what does that look like? Somebody actually marries for love, and they're a royal.
Well, my thing
in the royal family.
Yeah. I love about them, they come from the royal family.
Yeah.
Oodles of tradition are
dripping
from everything that they do. And he and she are very anti-tradition.
They are.
This is what I love about them.
I love it.
And that's what makes them come across so genuine and so sincere. They're like, you know, no, you know, they're scratching tradition and they're fucking it up, turning it up on his head. They're still respecting the certain traditions or finding new ways to tie them in, but they're not being puppeteered in any way. Like, I'll say, like, Harry and the other girl were.
What's her name?
Kate. Harry and Kate was,
That's William and Kate.
That's William. No, who's Harry? Prince William. One that's married Markle?
Yeah.
Yes.
Markle.
But if I did care, if I didn't. Now.
If I didn't, I can't. Don't.
That's okay. Now, I would just say, you know, it was very, oh my God, she's not a royal descent, and neither is Markle, but I feel like William cared a little bit more, to impress the traditions. And maybe the burden was on him because he's the big brother.
Yeah.
Harry has always kind of been his own little renegade. Maybe because he's a ginger, which I love.
I think so. I think it's a ginger.
I love that he marches to the beat of his own drum.
Right.
He's got his little mixed girlfriend and he's doing things his way, which people should do. Fuck tradition. Sorry, not sorry. Just fuck it.
I agree.
Yeah, but he still is respectable. He still is respecting a lot of things.
Yeah.
So he's not just out here just being a jerk about it.
No, he's not. I and that's what I do like about it.
He's putting himself first. Right. Like this is what we just talked about.
This is what's important to him.
Put yourself first. Like, he loves her. He wants what's best for himself. And she's it to him. So he's putting aside certain things that don't match up to the traditions of the royal family for her.
Do it for her. I love it. I love the fact that he doesn't want to have a prenup. Because it says a lot about him and how he views her in their relationship.
I think it's good for other people to see that because, you know, over here, while it may be not be as strict with certain traditions, you know, under the Queen's rule over there, but, you know, politicians, I think, go through some of those same pomp and circumstance kind of things. And that's why, you know, we keep overlapping with these whack-ass rules, whack-ass laws, because the younger generation of politicians and people in government are trying to impress the older generation.
Right.
Maybe the older generation didn't get everything right.
Right.
Up to and including the founding fathers. They fucked up. They weren't the brightest people.
Right.
You know, honestly, some of these people had second and third grade educations.
Yeah.
But yet our country and everything that we stand for is built under it.
Yeah, that's true.
Come on, son.
Yeah.
Let's get it together.
Yeah.
Good job not following the rules, you guys.
Yeah. Kiddos. I'm happy for you, Harry, and what's her name?
Meghan.
Markle.
Meghan Markle.
I remember is Markle. I'm sorry. So
Where is she from? Is she from Compton?
I don't know. I know she was an actress. She was on the scene.
Well, she still is an actress.
Wait a minute. Is she from Compton or is that like is she from Compton?
I don't know. Why are you always asking things? We got to
I know, like the fact-checking thing. But yeah,
I just like her. I'm really not that sure about.
But an interesting little fact here is she's on a TV show, Suits, and her character is getting married this season.
Oh, wow.
So she's on an actual show.
Oh, good.
She's
beautiful.
She is beautiful.
She is.
I think we're cousins.
Probably somewhere, you know, down the long line of cousins.
From the long line of slavery.
Oh, yeah. We're all cousins if that's the case. I mean, you know.
I'm sure if I told somebody that, they would believe it.
I can almost just about. It's like if you put, you know, belief on a scale from 0 to 10, I would say, like, I'm, like, at a full 2.5.
Wait, what? That's like, she's from LA, by the way.
She's from LA. But she's not from. Okay.
She's from LA. She was born in LA. Whether or not they lived in Compton, I don't know. She'd probably never fess up to it. She doesn't strike me as a keep it real kind of gal.
Did I just try to make her extra black?
Yeah, but that would be cool if the princess to be
straight out of Compton.
Straight out of Compton.
All up in your
buckets. All up in your buckets.
fucking ham. So listen, speaking of, I want to tell you guys about this.
Okay.
These are from some new friends I made who I'll be working with soon, and I'm excited about it. And I, you know, I say that lightly, working with. We still have to have a conversation, but whatever. So, the guys from MacFly Fresh made, MacFly made this. I was at a mixer for Charlotte Boom, which happened, I think, about a week ago. It's basically an arts festival that's very inclusive of different artists in and throughout the community. Okay. And so at the mixer, they were there on site doing screen prints, which they let me do myself. You can tell because it's messed up. That's because I did it. But, you know, I have a
crooked hand. So harsh on yourself.
Well, I have a crooked hand. Everyone knows this. I have a crooked hand and a crooked eye.
Do we?
We do what we can. No.
Okay.
Everybody doesn't know it, but now you know.
Now you know.
And knowing's half the battle.
G.I. Joe. Will that always be?
Yes. Okay. Yes.
Yeah.
When there is ignorance and then the realization of said ignorance, and now you know. It's always going to be half the battle.
Yeah, and it's always going to be G.I.
What's the other half of the battle?
I don't know.
That is the
What? So, yeah, 50%, you're good. 50%
of you. Figure out the other half.
That's why half life has never been full. It's never been whole. It's never been complete because we only knew half the battle. Joe. Thanks, G.I. Joe.
Thanks, Joe. Thanks, Joe.
That's hilarious.
What's the other half?
What's the other half? That's such a good question.
Anybody can answer what the other half of the battle is.
Please tell
like
us.
Like execution, being a good person.
What's the other half?
Breakdancing. What if breakdancing's the other half?
It could be.
It's not. Pop and lock it.
No, I think we're screwed.
What do you think?
Now
is?
That we're this
What
age,
could the other half of the battle be?
Maybe doing your research. I don't know.
Doing your research.
Dominance.
Maybe drinking 8 glasses of water a day.
Wine.
I don't know.
Oh, I thought you were going to go with wine.
No, you wanted to go with wine. And she just said wanted water. To go the healthy way. You said
8 glasses
wine.
Of wine a day?
Why not? Why not?
That,
why not?
That will definitely take your battle to a different level.
Yeah, it will.
A drunken level.
You want to be an alcoholic? That's the other half.
That's
of
the other half.
But what were you?
So, yeah. So, Charlotte Boom. I have to, you know, first of all, these guys at McFly, they, like, are these great dudes. I'm still, like, learning about everything that they do because it's not just screen printing and graphic design. Let me just tell you a little bit about. They do work in the Congo. They do a lot of community service and giving back, as far out as within Africa, which I think is super dope. So I'm going to be learning everything I can about these guys. And so you're going to hear a whole lot more. And I wasn't mistaken in saying MacFly Fresh. It's the MacFly Fresh Printing Company, but that's just one entity under the umbrellas of all the things that they do and have going on. So Google them, check them out, and you know, just you know, this is me keeping an eye on the streets of Charlotte for you, the people.
Yeah, because there's a creative side to this show. Crown Jewels is not just about three women that have a lot to say or want to talk about whatever we want to talk about.
Just running our
there's
mouths.
Like there's an artistic, you know, feel to this show. I think, like, we want to be a part of, like, we want to be a part of talking about what our community needs to hear, that you don't hear from women a lot of times, or you don't hear from women talking in public a lot of times. You say things to your friends, and then that's how you pass it along, or it's on Facebook, and that's how you hear about it, but you need to care about things. You need to care about other people in your community. You need to care about promoting healthy mental health and healthy mental health at that. You need to care about promoting things like this. I mean, even what it says, I know you didn't say that, but
the people
have the power. Like that in itself, that's a powerful statement, and we need to use that power. Use it for good. Don't use it for evil, Donald Trump.
Yep. speaking of arts and people, so, you know, we opened up the show with Miss Ida Devine's throwback classic, Grow Up, which I just love that because I think it ties into us. You know, we are technically grown-ups and adults, but, you know, we're all... You know,
still young at heart.
We really just are, you know, and I think that speaks to me on so many different levels because some people take themselves way too serious. You know, yes, we do have to grow up and be adults and adult, but that doesn't mean you lose yourself in the mix of that. But Ida, who I just absolutely adore, dropped a new single. I just want to tell you guys about it. It's called Waste Your Time. It's a dollar download, so check her ass out. She's going to be at the Maricopa Music Fest. I believe that's in Arizona. So she's always got stuff going on. She's in London. She's touring overseas. These are the people that have come from our home city. So, you know.
Ida Devine.
Yes. Support and invest in your people because I think it's important. And expand your musical palette, and she'll do that for you.
I did that.
Yes.
The people have the power.
The people do have the power.
Have the power. And Ida Devine needs our support.
And our power.
Yeah. Yeah.
Give her your power.
Well, no, don't give her.
Give her all your power.
Keep your powers.
Bend all yourself over to the divine. Okay.
Just get her down.
I don't think she wants all of that.
Yeah,
so.
She doesn't even want it.
The views and opinions expressed by me, not that of Ida Devine.
Or anybody else.
Or anyone else, right?
Well sometimes.
Know. Yeah. So.
But just not on that. Not on giving the power.
Give the power. Keep your own damn power.
Yes. And all use it.
Use your power for good and not evil. And that is the other half of the battle.
Ooh. Mind blown.
Using your power.
Dropping jewels.
Dropping jewels.
Bing, bing. That was the big one.
We need a sound effect machine.
Oh
damn. Boom. What jewel was that?
Because it was at the other half of the battle.
That was like a meteorite.
Yeah.
That machine would be broken.
It was the other half of the battle we finally had.
No, I know. It was the meteorite because diamonds can be formed from meteor crashes.
Oh, that's how she's going to bring it together.
Bam. I like science.
We'll just say. Yeah. We'll use it.
Science loving mother checker. What? I like science.
But that had nothing to do with
science. When the meteor comes down from the sky and it crashes,
then
the pressure and the heat. Pressure is not what creates diamonds.
There's someone who's watching that and
pressure
thinking
and
that
heat
is so.
Diamonds.
Yeah.
But it's the heat. It's the combination. It's the
heat. What? Sorry. Anywho's, well, as a recap, OJ, let's just not.
Recap him.
Yeah, then let's not recap him. Spring has not sprung. The groundhog is stupid. Well, no, he predicted
the groundhog is stupid.
He predicted 6 more weeks of winter. He's still stupid for doing that.
He's stupid. Okay.
Winter is dumb.
Is the groundhog stupid for predicting that, or are the people
stupid
for
listening to believing
it?
Exactly. That's you got to the root of the problem.
Well, that wasn't us though. So that wasn't my people. My people didn't do that.
It's not. So my birthday is coming up. Most importantly, was the topic of today's.
So is mine. December
19th.
It is coming.
It's still coming up,
but mine is coming up next after hers in July, and then yours. So you just have to be patient and wait. Everybody has to wait.
However,
that's how you know we're like big ass kids. Because why are we talking? It's my birthday.
It's my birthday.
But mine is before yours.
We talk about birthdays pretty often lately.
Okay, so her birthday is coming up in April, but for now, she and we are still accepting her birthday gifts. We're accepting early.
She and we. I love that.
She and we are still accepting lunch date, dinner date.
The she we. Do you know what a she we is?
You're going to look it up, aren't you?
Google she-we. But I invented that years ago, but whatever.
Why did you invent that?
Well, okay, so now we're going to have to get into it real quick. Shiwi is something that it allows ladies to stand up and take a pee. I invented it years ago.
Oh, that's what?
I invented it years ago because my mom used to play softball at the park that never had a bathroom back in the day. And I have brothers, so they could go pee as much as they wanted. She used to make me cop a squat. Now I have mental issues about copping squats out inside. You know, it's just not okay. Because that pee can just do what it wants. It can go wherever it wants, whatever it wants. Right. And I don't like it. So I took an empty toilet paper roll and used that to direct my pee. Booyah.
The shiwi.
The shiwi.
Wait a minute. Some men need that.
Yeah, they do. They... I can't help them. You can't be helping.
What can help them?
Nothing.
How do you miss? I mean, the toilet is it's a good size. It's pretty big. Yeah. How do you miss?
I live with three guys. You're asking.
How do you miss? Girl. How do you miss?
Yeah.
But how do you miss?
You just need a toilet like this.
Can somebody please explain that to me?
It seems
that the bathroom is their toilet.
The whole bathroom?
The whole bathroom.
Just aim better. Aim
high.
No.
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 Please don't
aim low in the toilet. Aim high.
In life and low in the toilet.
That is great.
Just aim directly in the toilet.
Now and don't do that wiggle dry shit. It slings pee everywhere, you dumbass. Use the toilet paper. Oh, I'm going to just wiggle this shit dry. I'm going to start wiggling my ass dry all over the goddamn bathroom. Now on.
With other women and other men so you can be a better self and make other people better.
Mm-hmm. Sexy Lexi, you gonna drop that last
one? All right, signing off. This has been...
We're not doing that anymore.
We're gonna do it again?
Yes.
We did it the last time.
We did it, so we had to do it.
But when I sit up straight, my bun goes out of frame. We want this... This bun took me a while to do.
So be shorter.
Why? I'm tall. She's not. Okay, at CNN, it doesn't take this long.
Thank you for tuning in to the Jewels. So, we're going to go out on Ida Devine's latest single, Waste Your Time. I'm Tika Rose.
Kelly Vaughn.
And Alexis Alexander. I'm the only one in the polls.
Oh. Peace out, Boy Scout.
Do it.
I ain't doing it. I'm going this way. 50% of the time.
It works.
Every time. Bye.
Bye.
Quickly do.